All right, guys, welcome back to the channel. We're about to hop into this Lindsey Stirling Survive featuring Walk Off the Earth. Let's hop straight into it. All right, they done lit something on fire. And smash the glass. Good Lord, Survive.
Three is gone. Two different stories in the life you led. One by one, there's pieces falling into place in my head. Of all the games you used to play, using my heart like it's yours for entertainment.
I like that. She said pieces falling into place in my head. So it's almost like she's coming to a realization of the manipulation, maybe, or the emotional games played by this person, played by her partner, basically, you know. But the lyrics do convey a sense of betrayal, and I guess the emotional toll of being used for someone else's entertainment, basically. Hold on, what the heck? Oh, she a detective? Inspector Gadget, she a cop, she got the evidence and everything. Okay, she know, yeah, she in the bag, you know, you gotta, you know, don't put your fingerprints on it. Then she got the magnifying glass. Like, she doing her thing.
Like it's yours for entertainment. You are the one, so now we're done. Baby, you showed me what I'm really made of. Now, baby, I'm alright without your love.
I will survive. So that right there, the I will survive part, that right there alone, that's the determination to move forward, let go of this toxic person, and continue to thrive on her own. That's how I'm looking at it. That's how I'm looking at it. You know, she's gonna find fulfillment within herself.
Now that you're free, enjoy the reason that you never called me.
I started thinking about something just now. It kind of almost comes off as in, like, you know, the guy will eventually realize what he lost, because she said, don't go and hit my line, I won't pick up. The only reason he could be calling your line is because he want to reconcile something that he messed up, you know, because 9 times out of 10 that's what people do. Your partner that messed up, they're not just going to call you for no reason to see how you're doing, you know. Or they're probably going to ease their way in, you know, small talk. And then before you know it, they're going to try to push their way in to, you know, reconcile the relationship. That's how it be. So when she said that, that's what kind of, that came to my mind right there, you know. So
I'm more than satisfied without your touch. You thought my love would die after what you've done. But I will survive.
Yo, I feel like this kind of serves as like an anthem to basically like regardless if you get cheated on, you know, nobody determines your worth. Like you know your worth, so even if you get cheated on, it's like, you know, it's not the end of the world. Like you can still go on with your life. You can still, you know, I guess you can still like find fulfillment in yourself, like I said earlier. You can still go on and thrive in your career without letting, you know, the heartbreak affect you and stuff like that. You can still thrive on with life, basically. You know what I'm saying? So, heartbreak or not, I think she just want people to realize, like, no matter if you've been cheated on, you can still do what you was doing before with going through the heartbreak. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm gonna leave it like that, and I hope you guys enjoyed this reaction. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Peace, we out, we gone.